Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create the look of vintage film frames from contemporary photos for versions CC and later. I provided a Photoshop template that you can download so you can follow along. Its link is in my video's description below or project files. It includes two layers, a vintage film frame and film scratches. Before we begin, if you're not already a subscriber to Blue Lightning TV, click that small subscribe button at the lower right corner. If my tutorials have helped you learn or improve in Photoshop, or even inspired you to explore your creativity, please show your support by joining my community of patrons on Patreon for as little as $2 a month. First, we'll change the blend mode of the film scratches to divide. If you toggle its visibility back and forth, you can see how the scratches add age and wear to the film. Open a photo that you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. We'll place it into the template I provided. If your Move tool isn't active, press V on your keyboard. Drag the photo onto the tab of the template. Without releasing your mouse or pen, press and hold Shift as you drag it down and release. Pressing Shift kept the photo centered over the template. Before we resize the photo, drag it below the film scratches. Open your Channels panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Channels. I provided a mask for the inside of the frame. Control-click or Command-click the shape to make it into a selection. Open back your Layers panel and click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to your photo. Click the Chain Link icon to unlink the photo and the layer mask. Doing this allows us to resize and reposition the photo inside the layer mask while the layer mask remains in place. To resize your photo, make the photo active and open the Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. If you're using a Photoshop version earlier than CC 2019, go to a corner and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out. If you're using CC 2019 or later, just press Alt or Option as you drag it. Then, press Enter or Return to accept it. Next, we'll convert the photo into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively and allow us to adjust the filters at any time. To do this, click the icon at the upper right and click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter, Blur Gallery, and Iris Blur. Go to the middle of the top or bottom of the blur ellipse, and when you see a curved double arrow, drag it up to the middle of the sprockets. Go to the middle of one of the sides, and again, when you see a curved double arrow, drag it out approximately this far. Make the blur amount 8 pixels. Open the Noise panel and make the amount approximately 50%. The size is 25%, the roughness is 50%, the color is 0, and the highlights are 100%. Then click OK. Next, we'll add a soft dark vignette along the edges. Go to Filter and Camera Raw Filter. Click the Presets icon. The grain is none. Once we add other filters to it, the extra grain won't be necessary. Make the vignetting heavy. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 0.3 pixels. Change the photo's blend mode to Multiply. Next, we'll add a black and white filter to fade the overall colors and to customize the brightness of specific areas of our photo. Click the Adjustment Layer icon and click black and white. I did an in-depth tutorial on this filter, so if you'd like to watch it, I included its link in my video's description as well. We want the adjustment layer to affect just our photo and not the film frame. Since adjustment layers affect all the layers below them in the Layers panel, we need to clip it or restrict it to the photo. To do this, click the Clipping Mask icon or press Alt-Control-G on Windows or Option-Command-G on a Mac. You can also go to Layer and create Clipping Mask. Reduce its opacity to 50 or 60%. To adjust the brightness of the tones of specific colors, click the On Image Adjustment tool. This tool automatically adjusts the gray tones of specific colors in your image. For example, I'd like to lighten the gray tones of the greens in my image, so I'll go to the trees and click and drag the adjustment tool to the right. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.